Arnica Montana. Now, Arnica Montana belongs to the Compositae family. Other remedies being Belly's Pearl, Chamomilla, etc. Now, Arnica Montana is a very important tissue remedy. Also, an important injury remedy, to be more specific. Now, when we're talking about injury remedies, there are a lot of injury remedies, like for example, Calendula, Hypericum. But Arnica Montana is specifically used for blunt injuries. Now suppose you are cutting vegetables in the kitchen and you cut yourself with the knife. At that time you won't think of Arnica, although it's an injury remedy, because that is an incised wound that you're going to have. And as I said, Arnica is used for blunt injuries. Now say suppose you are having a fight and someone gives you a blow. At that time we'll think of Arnica because it is a blunt injury, and Arnica's effect is seen tremendously in blunt injuries. Now I'll just give you a gist of the generalities of Arnica. Now, one big statement about it, that is so lame, bruised feeling, which is very painful. This statement, you know, sums up the whole remedy in a nutshell. Now, when we said it is a very good injury remedy, and we also said it is good for blunt injuries, but suppose, now you have a bruise, you have got a box and you've got a bruise, and it is nice and blue, but it is painless. At that time, we won't think of Arnica because there's no pain. And one of the characteristics of this remedy is that it is supposed to be a painful remedy. Trauma is another very important aspect of this remedy. Now this trauma, till now we were talking about the physical aspect of it. But then trauma even in the mental aspect, like you know some kind of hurt, maybe recent or maybe you know long or deep seated, that can also bring in the complaints of Arnica. When talking about mental trauma, now maybe a person had met with an accident, say like you know 4-5 years back, and maybe that person is still having PTSD. So in this case, although it is not a very you know near-seated incident that has happened in this patient's life, Arnica will work because we, as we said, the trauma could be recent or long-standing. It also has its major effect on the circulatory system. It affects the blood, causing septic and putrid conditions. It affects the blood vessels. There's a lot of dilatation and relaxation that takes place. Hence, Arnica is associated with a lot of ecchymosis, bruising, etc. It also has a very important action on hemorrhages. When there's any bleeding, mostly and more specifically internal bleeding, where it has no outlet to get out, in such conditions, Arnica will act as an absorbent. The discharges of Arnica are very foul smelling. So, you know, the sputum will be foul smelling, fetid. Even the discharges from the nose and any other discharges will have a very fetid and foul smelling characteristic to it. One of the major causative factors in Arnica is ill effects of any anger, ill effects of fright, and any ill effects of some financial losses or losses in business. Okay. Now going to the mind of Arnica. Now Arnica patients, we said they do not like to be touched. Now the same do not like to be touched aspect can be applied to the mind of it. These patients will never want, these individuals will never want to be hugged or touched or kissed or anything. They like to have their distance, you know. And also there's a lot of delirium in this patient. So say a doctor has come near them or you are there next to them and you ask them a question. Now this is a very typical aspect of the delirium of Arnica. In the delirious state also, the patient will come out, will answer it properly and then go back into the delirious state. Like for example, you ask the patient like, you know what, where is it hurting you? And the patient will come out and you know give you the full answer and then go back to the delirious state. But now say suppose you ask the patient like, you know, where is it hurting you? And the patient comes out of the delirious state and you know doctor and goes back into the delirious state. Now this wouldn't be a characteristic of Arnica. This is more of a baptisia state that we are seeing over here. Also, Arnica females, they do not like to be touched. Now, even when it comes to the sexual activities, they do not want to indulge in any kind of sexual activities. Not because they do not have any desire. The desire is there, but they have so much of fear of being touched, of being bruised. Because for them, to be touched is the last thing they would want. Okay? Another feature of Arnica, what Dr. Kent explains to us, which he has seen in one of his patients, is like, you know, the patient was sick and vomiting bigger stuff and had a very mortal look on his face, like as if the patient was on his deathbed. And yet, when the doctor comes to the patient, this patient goes like, "Who called for you? I am totally fine. You can please go home." So this, you know, this not wanting the doctor, not to be wanting to be treated is one important aspect we see in Agnika. Okay, now going to the head of Agnika. Relatively, when you see the head of the Agnika is hot compared to the rest of the body will be cold, whereas the head will be hot. Also, you will find, you know, spots of icy coldness on the head of Agnika. Now, this can be, you know, linked to the oversensitiveness of Agnika patient. Secondly, when the patient goes to sleep, he feels the pillow is too hard. So, this thing, Agnika patient basically have this sense in them where anything they lie on or anything they touch is too hard for them. Now, after the head, we'll go to the eyes. Now, we said there is a lot of sensitiveness in Agnika. So, a lot of reading or watching causes a lot of haziness and dizziness in these patients, and they are better by closing their eyes. Also, they can see a lot of flickering and sparks and sparks in front of their eyes. Secondly, what happens is there could be a lot of, you know, capillary bursting and hemorrhages that is seen. Okay, that's with eyes. Now, going to the nose, we said Agnika is used in hemorrhagic conditions too. So, there will be a lot of epistaxis that will be seen. Also, the nose will be very sore. Now, going to the ears, since we said like Agnika is a very sensitive remedy, that it cannot tolerate noise. Also, there will be a rush of blood to the ears and there will be a lot of bruising on the cartilage of the ears. Now, going to the mouth, now we said, you know, fetidness and putridness is one of the aspects of this remedy. So, the mouth, there will be a lot of halitosis, that is, the breath will be very fetid. Okay, secondly, the mouth is very dry and there will be a lot of thirst that is present. And this thirst will usually be for warm water. And the face, when we go back to the face, the full face will have a very sickly, deathly appearance. There will be like, you know, a very mottled look on the face. Okay, now going down, we go to the stomach. The stomach, this remedy has a lot of craving for vinegar. Yet, milk and meat is not tolerated. Okay, and they are very, very hungry people. They have something called canine hunger. Canine is usually a word we associate with dogs. So these people, like what they do is they eat. They eat a lot and then after some time they're hungry again. So this is the term canine hunger, is the term used for such a condition. Also in the abdomen, there will be sharp pains that are felt. Now going to the stools will be very fetid, brownish, yeast-like material. And the smell will be very putrid and fetid. Also, after passing each stool, the patient will be very prostrated and the patient, this will compel the patient to lie down. Coming to micturition, now as we have said, this is a very sensitive remedy. So, the micturation or urination also will be very painful. And one characteristic is there will be a lot of sediments in the urine which will be brick red like color. Okay. Now coming to the female reproductive system, as I have already told you all about the mental aspect of an Agnika female, where the female has a sexual desire but she doesn't want to be touched only because of the fear of it. Agnika has also a very important action in the physical aspect of the female reproductive system, especially after delivery or postpartum. Now what happens is that during the process of delivery, the female body undergoes and endures a lot of trauma. At this time, Agnika is very beneficial to the female. Secondly, maybe in case of mastitis, where the cause is, you know, source 12 injury, at that time, Agnika is very useful. Now, coming to the respiratory system, a lot of paroxysmal coughs are seen in Agnika. Okay? The coughs are whooping kind of coughs, and especially in children, you will see that, you know, even this coughing brings on crying, because, you know, the cough is so painful and inversely, even crying brings on coughing. Coming to the heart, there is angina present. It will be very painful and the pain will be concentrated on the left elbow. The pain that is there in the chest will be a very stitching kind of pain and the pulse of the patient will be very weak, feeble and irregular. Now coming to the extremities, as we said, it is a very, very painful remedy. So all the joints of the patient of the individual will be very painful. it is very it's a very useful remedy in gouty situation, especially when you know there's a lot of pain in the small joints of the fingers and of the toes. At that time, arnica helps relieve the pain. Coming to the skin is extremely sensitive. It cannot bear to even touch the bed, which is actually supposed to be soft, but in these individuals, they even feel their own bed to be hard. There will be a lot of bluing and bruising of the skin, and this bluing, bruising, and that is present in the skin or the ecchymosis will be very, very painful. As I said before, if pain is not there, it becomes a contraindication to use arnica, because pain is one of the main keynote system symptom of arnica. Okay, now coming to the sleep. Now these individuals have a lot of disturbed sleep because they dream of death and mutilated bodies. And usually what happens in the middle of the night when they're sleeping, they get up thinking that, you know, this fear of ghosts and robbers being there, that usually causes them to have a very non-refreshing sleep. Coming to the general modalities of this remedy, the aggravating factors, as you know, would be touch, any kind of motion, any kind of pressure applied, cold, damp weather. These are all the aggravating factors, and the aggravating factors would be lying down and keeping the head low. Okay, now I will discuss to you all a very interesting case I had in which I prescribed arnica. Now basically there was this 10-year-old student who had come to me, and she was like, her parents were complaining that she was just refusing to go to school. And so when I asked her like, why do you not want to go to school, she told me, "No doctor, early in the morning my stomach pains very bad." And she used to keep repeatedly complaining about the stomach pain to her parents, but they used to neglect it, thinking like, you know, she's just making excuses not to go to school. Now when I kept questioning, I found out that some months back this girl had a fall, was playing on the playground, and she had hit her abdomen in that fall. So, and there were no cuts, no bleeding, nothing. So this and some other, taking the full case also, I came to a totality which pointed towards arnica. Okay, so when this girl came back now to me, she told me, and her mom also, they told me like, you know, the pain, stomach pain is gone, that is there only. But you know, this girl had a long standing headache that she used to keep getting off and on and off and on for years together now. 2-3 years had gone by, and they had kind of started neglecting it because they had taken all other medications possible, and that headache was just not going. And that headache had started like, you know, when she was in the second standard, she had a fall and she had hit her head. From that time the headache was there. It was not a continuous kind of headache, but it used to come in her like on and off. And the headache had become like a part of her life, that, you know, they didn't even bother telling me like, you know, that headache is a complaint. So when I had actually prescribed the arnica for this, you know, injury that she had, which was causing the stomach ache, it actually cured the headache, which was caused by a very, very far-seated incident of the fall that she had. Okay, so this was all about arnica. Now just to sum it up, arnica is a very important blunt injury remedy where the injury is very, very painful. Okay, it has a sore, lame, bruised feeling all over the body, and the same feeling is also there in the mind. So the patient not only physically doesn't want to be touched, but mentally also the patient doesn't want any kind of interactions, doesn't like to be hugged or anything of that sort. The patient basically likes to be left alone. And there is also oversensitiveness in this patient. So whenever you see the complaints, say maybe like, you know, the ear complaints, it will be very sensitive to noise. Or say maybe it is the eye complaints, the patient or the individual will be very, very sensitive to light. So this, you know, extra sensitiveness that is seen in this in the generalities of arnica is seen in all the aspects, whether physical or mental.